Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Battleship321 blasting at you, and today I will be doing a video review, quite late actually. I was not supposed to do one yesterday, but I was otherwise busy doing laundry, and I had to focus on doing that. Abby, but here I am doing a review of Transformers Studio Series 86 Hot Rod. Now, as you can see, I do have almost all the accessories that he comes with right here. Except for the blast effects, there's one for the Matrix and two for his exhaust pipe forearm guns. I say guns with quotations because they're not actually, they're kind of like auxiliary weapons for Hot Rod, I think. Besides his primary ones, which he does have two of, two different ones, two different molds. It's like he has this one, but he tried to build this one based off of this one. I understand the G1 had two guns as well. Well, they're molded in, I think they're molded in the red plastic, but we do have this silver paint right here. You can actually see the little bit of detail on the barrels. Got these little insets, which is very interesting. I haven't noticed that actually before until I brought it closer to the camera. Got the stock, well, the little stock. This first one, and we have this. Which is interesting, it's like another auxiliary weapon. Now these are blast effect compatible. You have to have the ones with the hole in it in order to go around this little end of the barrel. Yeah, you can definitely tell. This is molded in red but painted silver. Now, on the vehicle itself, there's no place to actually store it on the vehicle mode. At least that I've been able to find. Unlike on the G1 toy, where I think it's G1. No, on the Titan. No, it was the Titans Return toy. Because both of the guns would clip together, and they'll both go into little ports on this little engine bit. So here is another one of the accessories, a saw, it's a buzz saw, which I think there might be no, there aren't. Thought there might have been repro labels for this, but I don't believe there are. You get two tabs there, a little bit of multi detail, not a whole lot. Not a whole lot, just a nice cool little buzzsaw that he has, that he used in the movie. And last but not least, we have a little itty bitty Matrix of Weedleship. It's so tiny. It's so tiny. Compared to a third party recreation of the Prime Matrix. Yeah, you know who wins in style. Prime had a really damn good looking Matrix. I mean, Prime as in the show, Transformers Prime. Speaking of third party. Ah! These are mainly for robot mode. But you can see back there, I do have a few third party accessories. Got a little bit of a training, like, not lightsaber. Totally not a training lightsaber. Molded in the orange plastic. And this little blue bit is painted, I believe. I don't believe these are two separate See, are they two separate? No, it's all one piece. Little training saber. Got a really good quality shield. A little bit of a flame, totally not flame decal. A lot of cool deco on the back of it. Now, I did get these over at TF Safari. And a little arm cannon. Which has the same little hole right here as the saw does. So, right where the saw goes, this can go. And it creates a little, like, arm gun. Which is really cool. Come on. Fine. Don't. All right. So, now we're going to put these lovely, lovely accessories to the side. Now, I did find my figure in a store. At my local Walmart. Or my local Target, one of the two, doesn't really matter, but I found one at a local store. You may be able to get Seducer, this guy, through Big Buy Toy Store. If not, you'd probably have to go through the secondary market in order to find him. What the hell is... You see, I use this one a lot, so how my figures do their thing, it tends to break up some of the ground there. So yeah, here's Hot Rod in his vehicle mode. Now, something to mention. Can't remember if it's this side or this side. Yeah, it's this side. No, it's this side. There is an issue with mine. Though granted, it's probably just from wear and tear on mine. But so this has kind of broke off, so you will see parts forming with this piece specifically. But oh, this is a really cool vehicle mode. This doesn't tab in all the way. Can I just like warp like that? Because I mostly have this guy in his robot mode anyway. You can essentially see most of what's going to be the robot. Eventually. Now, another issue that I found with this figure is the color matching sucks. Because you have this dark maroon, this lighter red, this very more like muted red, and it's all throughout the figure. Like, what the hell? Yeah, you have this darker maroon right here, and you have this lighter red right here. Light of red back here. You got this muted red. It's really weird how the color matching goes on this. Anywho, let's get down to transformation. But yeah, also, never mind. Before we go to transformation, the blast effects, which are blue, that can go onto these. Well, technically, this end of it. It can also go on the back of this. To kind of be like exhaust. So anyway, yes, let's get down to transformation. Alrighty. So what we're gonna do is split the legs apart. Now they're just tabbed into the central frame here. What you wanna do is take this up so we can get that, turn it and bring it up a little bit just so we have that out of the way. We're going to untab these. We kind of just flip up, bring it around, and I'm going to probably put this piece into this hole right here. Doesn't actually just hold in it there, it just holds that there. So, that's another thing. Untab. Yep, this is the one that comes off, so we're going to set this one aside. So we're going to take this, and I want to bring it down, but I don't think we do that yet. All right, bring this Okay, so we untab this, because this just tabs in. See this little itty bitty tab right here? Tabs into underneath there. Behind the wheel. Bring this. Kind of got to turn it to the side and bring it out. Then we can bring the foot out. Or the leg out. Now on this double hinge, you're going to make sure it is nice and straight. Bring the foot out. And as you see, it does have a little bit of ankle movement. You can flip in the wheel on this hinge. The hinge right there. That little pin is. Fold it in here. Bring it up into here. And just gonna repeat the process on the opposite end. You're gonna untab, flare out, bring it out, extend, flip in, flip the foot out, bring this in, and it's same with this leg here, where you see these two little tabs right there. On each side of this back of the wheel, we'll go into these two little notches right here. Like so. And at this point, we can turn the main body around. I believe we can start by making progress by opening this up. Yeah. So we can bring this up, and we're going to fold these ends of the car inward. And then, what are we going to do here? Right, we're going to bring this back a second. We can flip out the head at this point. Now, just because I prefer him looking like this better, I put his visor up. All you gotta do is open up his cranium and, you know, pull it back like that. She goes all the way back and boom, there you go. Got a hot rod with no shades. I like him with the shades. I think he looks nice with the shades. He looks cool with the shades. So you can bring, where's this tabbed into? Where the hell is this tabbed? Oh yeah. Okay, that's tabbed into there. So you can bring this around. Untab, bring this around. Bring this around. Be able to bring. Yeah, bring that around. Ah! Everything's going crazy. Okay. Move this up a little bit so you guys can see what I'm doing. Yes. Yes. Okay. So once these are folded in, bring this and bring it down. But before that, again, twist this from here. Twist this around. Bring the hood in, and then bring it down like, yeah, and then bring it down like so. Come on. Don't be like that. There we go. Then we're going to bring it in. Voila. Now we're going to bring this up. So this tab right here is going to go into this bit right where the back of the engine was. And that's just going to clip in the back there. And there we go. There is our good boy Hot Rod in his robot mode. Oh, and let's not forget about this little piece. We can just probably just pop that in. Because on mine, that broke. Bit of wear and tear. Yeah, there's supposed to be one on each side. And this one, not the greatest. Wear and tear will get you. Wear and tear will always get you. Just plug it back in and I normally just use this back piece. Right here just hold it in place. So there's Hot Rod in his robot mode. Again, it looks like a really cool robot mode. It really does. I like it. I enjoy it. It's one of my favorite Hot Rod characters. Or Hot Rod figures. And just for size comparison, here is with the G1 reissued Hot Rod. Because why not? Nothing beat the classics, right? I mean, this is the better one, by the way. And here he is with Little Steve. The totally not hard to steal Transformer version of the Thomas the Frickin' Tank Engine. Yeah, totally not. Here he is with the Core Class Wheelie. Studio Series G1 Wheelie. Not too bad. And here he is with Monkey Man, Optimus Primal in his beast mode. I feel like the Studio Series is going to be like a big Voyager class. Like, not quite Jetfire sized. No, that's Commander class. Like, maybe Armada Megatron Voyager. Maybe. Who knows? Anyway, let's go with accessories. We'll go with the official ones first. Here's his guns. We can give him his guns. What warrior or commander of the Autobots would he be if he did not have his guns? It just going to his hands, as usual. Let's put those over to the side. And he can hold the Matrix, but not in his chest. Just kind of got to put it with his hands up and kind of just do that. Can he do the scene from the movie? Kinda? When he's opening up the Matrix and accepting the burden of being a Prime. Or the mantle of being a Prime. And now this is definitely going to help with, for one of the third party, specifically this one, for his buzzsaw. It's just this arm. What you can do is just open this up, spin his fist around, gonna reveal this peg. Pop it in here. Pop it in. I said pop it in. There we go. And he has a saw. So we can just cut a whole lot of holes down, I guess. Don't know why he'd do that, but, you know, he had it in the movie. Speaking of which, we're going to keep that peg hand out for a second. A thing that this side does, is that you turn it around. This one can do the same thing. It's a welding tool. Like what you use to help, repair a cup when they're underwater on Junkion. That's cool. That's neat. It would have been cool if, We could just have something different, but hey, that's cool. I like options. Now for this one, which I love displaying him with the most, is this. Because not only am I a fan of this for Transformers, just part of an arm turning into a gun. This kind of harkens back to the Power of the Primes trilogy, or the Prime Wars trilogy, I believe it's called, where I believe Rodimus Unicronus had one, which there is going to be a Shatterglass Hot Rod coming, and I'm going to get it. Because I bought two of these. I'm going to repaint the other one black to match that particular one. And from what I've seen, it is a repaint, an overall repaint, with a remolded head. So if it has this same gimmick, I will be doing this. I will be. Oh, God. Been a while since I watched that movie. Put in the comments if you know which movie I'm talking about. Alright, now, same thing works. It's the same size peg. Gotta make sure his fists are closed for the shield and the training saber. Here we are. And he is more of a hand-to-hand warrior. Put him in a pose. This guy does have quite a bit of articulation. You can get him in quite a few poses. Granted, not all of them are the best. Like, I do have issues with the feet specifically. Look at his feet. But because of how they transform, the feet doesn't extend all the way out. Like, we have his back cable kind of hanging out over the legs, so it kind of throws off his balance. So I'm recently just caught to use, you know, these more awkward poses to do with the feet, at least, to get him into these cool action poses. All right, get him into a nice pose for the end shot. There we go. Alrighty. So, that just about does it for the Transformers Studio Series 86 Deluxe Class Hot Rod. Now, I picked mine up at my local Walmart. He might be available on either Hasbro Pulse, Amazon, or I want to say Big Bad Toy Store, but I'm not entirely certain. I'm definitely looking into getting the Kingdom Rodimus, because I don't think they've come out with a Studio Series Rodimus. I think Kingdom's the closest we're going to get. But yeah, all in all, that's all I got. I mean, it's a really cool toy. I do recommend it. He does have some small coloring issues, but it's a really good mold. Some small hang-ups on the transformation, but nothing I can't get past. But overall, this is a good figure. I do recommend it. And I did, so these extra accessories, they don't come with Hot Rod. I got these off of TF Safari, which has a litany a whole cadre of upgrade parts for your different figures. Like, for frack's sake, I have an entire bag if I can fucking find it. Where is it? Oh, it's over there. I'm gonna go over and grab that. Anyway, yeah. There's a large cadre of weapons and just minor accessories. Toy Hacks probably has a couple labels for him. I don't know if they do. They probably do have a few. They probably definitely have, you know, repro labels for good old Hot Rod here. Or G1 Hot Rod. This is the reissue. Even though I have Rodimus somewhere. Oh, I know where he is. Anyway. Yeah, so that is all that I gotta say about freaking Hot Rod over here. He's an overall good figure. I enjoy him. And I bet you will too. And I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts, so don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on this video of what you would like to see next. And, that's all I gotta say. I've been your host of Battleship 321. And I'm signing out. Let's wreck and roll.